A list has all the properties of a collection, so it has a group of things, but the objects have an order. A shopping list, while not really something programmers deal with a lot, happens to have a lot of the same properties as the list we use. There are things that might not have the same type of object, but they're still related to everything else on the list. The order doesn't mean much, it's just the order that I ran out of each item. And there's no fixed length. I could just keep adding things to the end, or adding and removing from the middle, and it doesn't really affect anything. Again, what exactly the implementation looks like for adding elements will change based on the language and the type of data structure. We're still talking theoretically here, so don't sweat the details too much yet. In this lesson, we'll explore several types of lists. Different programming languages treat them differently. Sometimes a list is incorporated as a core feature of a programming language, but what that looks like can vary wildly. The videos here will talk about the theoretical concepts that could apply to any language, while the text will explain the language-specific implementations.